The common birds we see every day and may take for granted are disappearing, studies show. According to one report by the New York Times, there are 2.9 billion fewer birds in the United States and Canada than there were just 50 years ago. Independent researcher and founder of SwallowConservation.org, Mara Silver, sat down with Connecting Point's Zydalis Bauer to talk about one of the native species being affected, the barn swallow.
I think ornithologists have known about declining populations for a while, but it sort of crept up and reached a point where it's noticeable now, and studies are showing that during the last 50 years, we've lost like 30% of our birds across groups. It's very alarming, actually, because it included some of our more common birds. The impact that humans have had on the planet has, you know, negatively affected some of these species, and we're finally seeing that play out now.
Now, I know that you are an expert in particularly barn swallows. Mm-hmm. Talk to me about the effect of that decline, especially in this region.
Well, the northeastern part of North America, in this region, we are seeing pretty severe declines in a group of birds called aerial insectivores, mm-hmm. of which barn swallows are a member of that group. And these are birds that eat insects while in flight. Barn swallows are declining across most of North America, but the decline is much steeper the further northeast you go. And we don't really know the reasons for the decline. There are factors implicated, like habitat loss, agricultural intensification, climate change, and some effects from climate change, even threats on their wintering and migration routes, because they spend the winter in Central and South America. So they have a long distance to go to come up here to migrate and then go south to winter. And so we have half the number of barn swallows in Massachusetts that we did in the mid-80s.
And I understand that there is a barn in Hadley that about 37 pairs of the barn swallows are nesting. What's going on with that barn? Because I understand that it might be at risk to be demolished.
Yes. So that colony of barn swallows nests at Fort River Refuge, which is owned by U.S. Fish and Wildlife in Hadley, Massachusetts. And it's an abandoned stable. It's called Brymar Stable. And it hosts the largest known colony of barn swallows in Massachusetts. We just don't know of another colony that has more nesting pairs. Our group, Save Our Swallows, is comprised of community members, scientists, volunteers, all working to save that stable because it's threatened with demolition by U.S. Fish and Wildlife.
I was reading that you all are very dedicated, which is amazing, and a lot of people are volunteering their time, not only their time, but their money as well. Where does that passion come from?
They're a beautiful bird, and they feed on insects that humans find to be pests, like mm-hmm. mosquitoes. And so there's just a fondness for these birds in this colony, and the fact that it's on a refuge, we feel it's worthy of saving.
Regardless if you are an avid bird watcher, it affects all of us the same, correct? Talk to me about some of those effects on the ecosystem and why people should care and why this is an important topic.
These birds are native, and biodiversity is a positive thing. Mm-hmm. And if we can save a native species, we should, because ecological systems are complex and we don't understand all the interactions involved in them. And the precautionary principle really should come into play when talking about and thinking about conservation of our native bird species.
Absolutely. And I also understand that there's going to be a protest. How can people get involved if they're interested and they're passionate about this topic also?
Time is running out for these swallows. So the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service is federally mandated to do a sort of weigh the pros and cons of a proposed action that's going to affect the environment. And so they had to do what's called an environmental assessment. And our group feels that they have sort of broken some of the rules involved in that process. And we have a legal team behind us, and we have filed an intent to sue. But thus far, we feel like we want to show that this stable is important to the public as well. We've got that legal angle, But if people want to show their support for their native bird species, I mean, it's easy to feel sort of hopeless when you hear all that bad news, but there is something you can do for native birds in your backyard, which is attend our Save the Swallows protest event. We're calling it the Last Stand for the Swallows on Saturday, November 16th from 10 to noon in Hadley at the entrance of Staples.
And what is the significance of the structure of this barn for the swallows? Because some people might be like, why can't they just nest somewhere else? Why is this structure significant for the species?
Well, there's a couple things. One, it is a large structure. And two, it's surrounded by open fields that are protected. They're not sprayed with pesticides. So as I said, these barn swallows feed on insects. So we have to assume there's good prey base there for them for feeding. And but the broader question is, we don't know why they like it so much. And because of that, because we don't really understand habitat selection in barn swallows, and they are choosing to be there in great numbers, this seems like a great opportunity to try to figure out why they're disappearing from some other barns, but they're thriving at this barn. It could be the structure of the interior of the barn. They build mud nests inside. It could be, again, the surrounding landscape combined with, you know, the structure of the inside of the barn. But there's a lot we don't know.